right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the C Bazz Cast. Make some noise, some more noise.
Woo! The C Bazz Cast.
All right, we are here. We are live. Just want to thank everybody real quick. I feel really thankful tonight.
Right.
I feel really thankful. It's been a lot to get us to here.
Right.
But we are here. So this is our first episode.
Right.
And this is basically the episode we titled The Redo. Because last week we did something, but it didn't work out too good. So this is the redo.
The right. Redo.
Okay. So, without further...
And in the world of comedy, by the way, one redo is pretty okay. That's a solid... That's
so
a
we
solid
can, I agree with that.
So we getting stimmies since we're doing a redo?
Okay, now you're pushing for too much. So anyway. Without further ado, I just want to introduce the cast, you guys, man. Of course, I'm going to start off with me. Your boy, C Bass comedian. How you doing? Welcome. Thank you. Good to be here. Hallelujah. To my right, your left, my man, comedian Wes Ross.
That's me. That's
in the building. You know what I'm saying? Kind of still fresh from New York. Kind of still fresh a little
bit.
Yeah,
yeah. I'll say I'm just got off the plane.
Yeah, you ain't fully unpacked yet.
They don't know. I just got off the plane.
They just got the plane. Spirit,
yeah.
Right?
Okay. Yeah, yeah.
All right, we talked about it. And my man, DJ G Y M C. Oh, well, I'm gonna say this, man.
I was expecting like a bum, 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 bum.
You know, I have to give you a special shout out though. It is National DJ Day all across.
Appreciate it.
America, the lower 48 states.
Salute to all the DJs out there, man. Happy DJ Day.
Hey, to all the DJs.
Thank you for your
make
service.
The promoters pay you.
That's right. Today's price is not,
yesterday's price.
I've been wanting to say that since I started writing the season. I've been wanting to get that out. So shout out to Fat Joe. So I'm gonna ask that, you know, the bartenders would just bring my man a shot up here. If you could just bring my man a shot. What kind of shot you want?
It's
taking him too long. Taka Vodka.
It's one of those. I need a shot that let a dog go see a cat.
So we're going to give you a shot.
Think about that one. All right.
Alive on air, just because, man, without a DJ, I wouldn't be where I'm at today. That's real. As a comedian, DJs do so much.
Super necessary.
Sound got to be right.
Appreciate it.
Hear us. DJs mean a lot, so thank you, brother.
Appreciate it, man. Appreciate it.
And in doing so, now, hold on. I'm a Google expert. I'm a Googler.
Right.
I'm a Googleologist.
Google.
I don't know the correct term for it. I'm a Googleator.
A Googleist.
Okay, I'm a Googleist. And I use the Google all the time, right? So, in using the Google, I had to check out, well, is there a National Comedian Day? Mm-hmm. And there was.
When is it?
November 7th, yo.
Oh, wait.
All right.
Yeah. So I thought it was going to be like a joke, like February 32nd or something like
right,
that.
Right.
But it actually really, really, okay, there's the shot. All right.
Hey.
Shout out. Yeah.
Appreciate it. If y'all want me to take this right now on camera, I will not.
No.
Do you understand how much shot?
No. You got to do it. I mean, this is the show. We got to get the ratings up, bro.
It's
the first episode. The network want to see something. Shout out to the Antidote Network. They got the hottest shows. We got to be right with them.
Up to it.
All right.
Down to it. So, we do it because we're used to it.
That's an old fraternity. Woo!
So drink. I can't say the word drink. Like I can't say the word drink.
Hey, good job, man.
I just shot the smallest sip of beer I've ever had. It was the most pathetic shot I've ever taken.
I got a straw.
In my defense, 200
pounds, I got
beer.
A straw. That's right. Better leave me alone with my straw. Anyway, we drink on the show as well, too. So, now, it is time that we really do our thing. Because the show doesn't feel quite right just yet.
No, it feels a little off.
You know, you're here, I'm here, DJ G YMC is here, but we need something to... Now, I'm beautiful.
Uh-huh.
You okay. I'm beautiful. Dre,
right.
We'll talk about it. So what I'm saying is that we need that niceness.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to make a little room on the couch. You're going to slide down. Slide that way.
Oh, I was
slide
about to say, I'm all the way on this.
I appreciate you went away. Microphone is actually under the pillow, so don't sit on the. You just sat on the microphone. We gotta get some new ones, so don't. Okay, so, hey man, make some noise for our newest member, Kelsey beat. What up, what up? Oh, okay, we're gonna give him just a look. Just a little bit. Shout out to Kelsey B with the fur. It's cold outside.
Had to bring the mic out.
I like the shark tails look.
You like
yes.
it?
Yeah, yeah.
You like
shark
it?
Shark
hey.
The fins and stuff?
Yes.
I'm a sexy fish.
Yeah, I'll go with.
No disrespect, bro. No disrespect.
Welcome, Kelsey B. Welcome, welcome. We're glad to have you on our show. You're a funny comedian. The people are going to love you. You impressed us like crazy. So welcome to the team. Is there anything you want to say real quick to the people? What you want to say? Just anything you want to say.
I mean, no, man. Just like, you know, rock out with your cock out.
Okay.
That's my motto.
There it is. All right.
That's what I do.
Well, you have to have a motto when you start here.
You do.
And my motto is eat at Quarters. They got the best food in the world. So that's
it.
So,
shout out to Quarters.
Shout out to the grind. You know what I'm saying? Shout out.
It's the chicken tenders for me.
Right. Now, I'm going to do something really quick before we get into our little topics. My brother is here. My brother is here. My brother, as they say, in law, in love, however you want to say it, he's here and he's celebrating his birthday.
Yeah.
And I just think it would be cool if we just gave him a little quick little birthday, little shout out.
Should we do like the rhymes? Happy, happy birthday from me to you. Happy, happy birthday from the C Bass crew. Hey.
Actually,
good ending on that.
I love
yeah,
you.
Well,
hey.
Yeah,
well, that's what talent. Talent would do that for
birthday.
You. Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday! There he is in the back.
Should
happy birthday!
Should we like yeah. gang up on him and crack?
Happy
and
birthday
like
to you! Happy birthday to you!
That's like a hood prize.
Happy
going to rhymes on your birthday.
That used to be, but I'm gonna tell you, the rhymes had the
you
best.
So accomplished.
The best.
Rolls.
Bread. Rolls.
The,
exactly.
the best. That honey butter. That honey butter. Boy, put that honey butter on there. Boy, I tell you. I'm sorry, I get excited.
When my daddy used to take me to Ryan's for my birthday, I felt like $1 million.
Yes.
I probably had this fur.
Yeah, yeah. Shout out to the fur, man.
Shout out to
the you know
fur.
What I'm saying? This is a special time of
he
year.
Don't do
we
it
get,
because it's faux fur.
In Louisiana. Faux fur. In Louisiana, we get 1 week to wear because it's only
my
cold
up. I'm
for 1 week.
An animal.
It's only cold for 1 week. So this, I'm glad you wore it this week because it's probably going to be
I
85 degrees
it
tomorrow.
Out this like last 5 days.
Yeah, you nice. Yeah. You look
I had
nice
it for
though.
A couple years, finally got cold.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm loving it. You know, you got because you can't really necessarily put it all the way up. You got to keep it
you
just
can't.
In case.
And I got a long trench when I'm going to wear that one next time.
Ooh,
hopefully
okay.
it's cold next time.
It's going to be cold next week.
Now that one, Peter
yeah.
going to be.
Yeah. You got to be careful.
They going to be
know,
on.
Man. I walked out one time with a trench. It was about 6 to 8 degrees, man. I passed out. I was sweating. It was bad.
It don't
it was
stay
a bad
cold
look.
Long.
It
don't
stay
cold
long,
long
cold.
Enough for a trench.
It don't. It ain't right.
You know, it's short now, but the yeah. longer it gets, the colder it gets.
Right. Even today, bro, like at noon, I was like, all right, it's still, it's like hot now.
Yeah.
Like it,
right.
It go from hot and sunny to rainy.
Now, we're going to talk about a little topics real quick.
Sip your little sweet drink.
Let's talk about Gary Chambers.
Gary Chambers.
Gary Chambers.
The only politician.
The only politician. Now,
I rock with your boy.
I don't know if we still, are we still video capable? Are we able to do it?
No, we didn't get a chance to
we're
do it.
We're not able to, okay. So we were going to play the video up on the screen. We'll get to that. But you guys got to know about it. He basically
smoked it.
His campaign ad.
That's what I would have did.
And it looked kind of good. But I just.
And it was a fat.
I was about to say, he had like
a
backwood.
Hey, he had a backwood. He had a honey backwood.
Yeah, I kind of wanted to go smoke with him. Like, you can't do that by yourself.
I'm like, first of all, hey. That's like Gary. That's like 3 grams in there, Gary. Are
you
sure
it was a
you
backwood?
Might be pushing it?
He was behind a Family Dollar off Greenwood Springs. Where was he at? Where was he at, man?
I don't even know.
Who's the location
he was in
scout?
A random chair in a field.
Yeah. It was like, he just out there.
I'm like, how did that chair.
He was talking
get
about like
there.
He was talking about like minor pot possession. I'm like, bro, you got like a 3.5 grams right
you
now.
Got like
bro, what
half,
are you talking
you
about?
You got a good 7 grams in that bag.
Yeah,
of
that was a jerk.
So I feel like you're over the legal. But you know what? It's Gary, you know?
I love it. I love it. No, I love it. And actually, we're getting a little more, kind of a little more woke on the C Bass Cast.
More woke.
There's a lot of issues
woke.
Going on, even right here in our community as well as nationwide. So. We got a special guest tonight, which is going to be my guy, man, good friend, man. He's the president of the NAACP.
Whoa.
BR chapter.
Whoa.
He just ain't no anybody.
You better snap.
Anybody. Got a nice jacket. Got a very nice jacket.
Very nice jacket.
Eugene Collins.
Can we talk about how fresh we look on our set now?
We do look nice. I'm very excited.
We
all
voted for the couch.
Yeah.
Hey, it was a 2-1.
Yes.
I'm glad I didn't win.
Well, it's kind of. What did you even? Did you even comment back?
I don't think he did.
Does furniture ever matter with me?
Right.
So
we did a. Yeah, that's right. You can't really sit down on it.
This was actually my first couch, my first appointment.
Really? That was the same couch? Really? That was it?
Yeah, I got it outside the road.
Shout out to Runner Center.
I know Big Lots when I see it. This is a Big Lot couch, and I know it.
I light-sawed it real good. I was like, I'm sitting there, I'm sleeping, you heard?
Right. Hey, well, shout out.
So just bring back memories.
Shout out to the Grind Quarters for allowing us to use this furniture. It's much nicer. Than like the chair. Yeah.
It's right. More intimate. The chairs feel kind of prisony.
Yeah. But we're going to make our guest sit in a charred chair here because you got to earn your way on the
side.
So we're
going to turn his chair into our table into his chair.
Okay. Be lucky you got a chair. Ain't no easy way out.
That's kind of disrespectful.
We earned furniture. Like, we've been doing this for 4 seasons. We earned some furniture.
Y'all find it.
Who was on buckets if I was sitting on?
Nigga, we make.
I was beating on the bucket.
On this network?
You're good. I think you're fine. Ando's fine. We can cuss on Ando. It's just
I'm one of them.
You one of those?
I'm one of them.
I got you, man.
Real
well,
good,
look,
baby.
Well, I'm excited. What we're going to do is, how we looking on time? How we look? We good?
We need to go to break.
Okay, good. So what we're going to do is go ahead and take care of our sponsors. We're going to go to break. We're going to be right back after this, man. And
where we at?
We at the Grind. Right back.
All right. I have a special, super special guest here today with me. The one, the only.
Big Cheese, the outlaw.
You understand me? You know, listen, I got to do it. I know you like that chicken.
Yes. So you know, I don't know how you know.
I'm keeping it chicken today, okay? So we're going to do my boy some honey mustard chicken. I got an episode that you don't want to miss. I'm digging all up in his business, you heard me? He got a story that needs to be told, and you don't want to miss it. Cheese, tell him where to find you at.
Hey, man, you can find me with the Innovative DJs. You can find me with Go DJs LA, and, of course, the Antidote DJs and antidote.com. Your place for music, culture, and sports.
That part. Okay, do not play with him. What's your social media tag?
Oh, at Big Cheese Outlaw. At Big Cheese Outlaw, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.
Do not play with him. Okay, y'all better look him up. You don't want to miss this. Keep it locked in for pressure.
Hi, I'm songwriter, producer, and recording artist Rich Samir of Vegan Trap Chicken. You can follow me on Instagram at Rich, SEMERE, or at Vegan Trap Chicken.
It's your girl, Yanni Badass. You can go ahead and follow me on Instagram at _ YANNIEBADAZZ. That's me.
Check out our episode of So Rogue BR on the Antidote Network on Fire TV, Apple TV, Roku TV, and YouTube.
Don't forget to please like, share, and subscribe if you like us. And au revoir, mes amis.
Tap in.
Okay, so I'm JG. Make sure to watch Full Disclosure, where we're going to talk about what's going on in the world, news, information. We're going to talk about what's going on with you, what's going on with me. So, make sure to watch us on the Antidote Network. You can find it on YouTube, Roku, Apple TV, and Fire TV.
What up, y'all? Yeah, look, man, I don't know if y'all niggas know about that Via Life or not, but look, y'all get on that Via Life. Precious shit, you know.
Indeed.
You know what I'm saying? Bitch, fit your arms real good. You know how back in the day how the brothers' t-shirts used to fit your neck? Yeah, they gonna bite that neck, bite them biceps, you know. Yeah, fuck with Via Life. It's retarded.
Brushing shit. Believe that.
Yeah. Hey, welcome back. Welcome back. C Bazz.
Cass.
Kelsey.
B.
Wes. Ross. DJ GYMC.
GYMC.
Jinx, you owe me a soda.
Yeah, get your mind correct for those who don't know what it's
stands
for.
That's the Cash App.
What does it stand for? I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's DJ Day, so, you know, Cash App. DJ GYMC. Or if you don't, or if your fingers can't reach that D, just $ the C Bazz Cast. If that's easy for you to type in, you sit it there. So, I don't want y'all to get carpal tunnel, so just C Bazz is easy to do, so don't worry about it. Just saving lives. You know what I mean? Just one person at a time.
One ligament at a time.
Just making my impact out here, man. You know? So I want to again shout out, man, definitely the Grind for having us here. And shout out the Antidote Network. Again, we're excited to be on the network. So show my love of YouTube, Roku, Amazon, Fire Stick. You see them all. Apple TV, all that. So, yeah. And we got some sponsors to shout out, too. Who we got to shout out, Kelsey?
Credit Stars. If you go to Credit Stars, you will go far.
There you go. And Intelligent Mortgage.
Because without your credit, you can't even get a mortgage.
You can't get the mortgage.
So you might want to be intelligent about it.
Yeah.
Yep. And they're everywhere. Credit Stars nationwide. Doesn't matter where you're at. Doesn't matter. Intelligent Mortgage is licensed in 5 states.
5?
Louisiana.
That's tough to do.
The SIP.
Texas. Unfortunately.
Tejas.
Bama.
Boom.
Florida.
Go Gators.
They got some big houses in Florida. So,
big houses. Ooh.
So, yeah. So, I mean, you know.
Florida got some shotgun houses for like $500,000. You like, I could have just stayed in Baton Rouge.
Right. That's
true.
Hey,
you know what? When we
I'm
make
about
it.
To go get a 2-bedroom with wood floors.
Right.
For $500,000.
Yeah. Well, you know, like the house, like, you know, I lived in L.A. for several years. So, you know, the house, the Friday house, like Craig.
Yeah,
house,
you stay there?
That house, no.
Okay.
But I can tell you this, that house is worth, now here, that house worth $47,000.
Right.
Right. Yeah. A good,
out there, that house worth about $870,000.
Right, but our good friends at Intelligent Mortgage can get you.
Can get your mortgage rates low.
Exactly.
Yeah, that gets you a good rate.
They're in California. There you go.
They sure are. Yep.
Can they get me a house in like
Gardier?
No, in the middle of like
Gardier. I fear. Gardenians.
Shout out Gardier, man.
No tear. All right. So what?
Please
come here. No. What'd you say?
I'm just trying to see if Intelligent Mortgage and Credit Stars can help me get me a big old house in like the middle of Natchez.
Yes.
Oh yeah.
Natchez,
Mississippi.
In the SIP, right there.
Like
right by Woodville. Yeah. I need it right between
London.
Woodville.
These are like Natchez. Bro, they can do Natchez all day long.
All my life, I want a house right here in Natchez.
All my life, I wanted a house in Natchez.
Right next to where the slaves died. Right there. That's where I want to be. Right there. I feel good.
And Wes turns his head like,
nope. I tried to get out of frame.
Oh, we're going to have all kind of awkward moments with you, Wes.
Yeah, we're going to,
Wes, you know how we get down. That's why I'm glad you're a comedian, because you understand. It's okay. The world is so serious. It's okay.
You know,
right.
Wes,
I don't
want to
be canceled. That's like my biggest fear.
Right.
To be
right,
canceled. Because I'm going to say anything. You got to know that. I'm a real hood baby.
Yes.
Real hood baby. And I say anything.
I'm a country boy. I'm a country boy, man. You know.
You got a little filter.
You know, grew up.
You might not get canceled as fast as me. I feel like I'm canceled in my near career.
Wow.
Let's see what happens.
They're like, Kelsey B, she said some ignorance. I always say ignorance.
Well, you ain't getting canceled on the Seabass Cast. Tell you that. You hit
and,
fake,
and
girl.
And not on the Antidote Network.
You have all the season
long
episodes.
As they don't cancel me, I'm never canceled.
Right, absolutely. Absolutely. She good. So, I'm going to go ahead and keep it moving, man. I want to bring up, each show now, we do a segment called Business Spotlight. And what that is we actually spotlight one of our sponsors.
Right.
You know, and that's a way of kind of getting them a little more exposure, but also talking about their business. And we still have fun with that. We're going to do that right before we bring our major guest on for the evening. So without further ado, we're going to call Mr. Fred Sargent, CEO of EmediaGC.com.
So Fred will be our minor guest, yep, since we haven't seen our
The GC
major
stands
guest.
For...
Right.
Give it up for the
minor.
Gulf Coast.
Hey.
Get your cups.
We at the grind.
We at the grind.
Well, we at the grind.
and C Bazz can meet. I'm here to talk to you today about the Antidote Network and why you should be watching it. It's got shows like Just Landed, Pressure, Kicking the Real. That just name a few. It's got the hottest artists, the hottest guests, the hottest hosts. So check it out, watch it. And all you gotta do is go to Roku, the Antidote Network, Amazon Fire Stick, YouTube, Apple TV. It's available everywhere. So get into it, check it out, and watch it.
Hi, it's Michael Armstead, and this is Tubby. Tune in to watch this amazing interview and see what's under Tubby's beret.
My baby right here, this, you know, when it hit the floor, everybody turned into zombies, you know what I'm saying? This is the zombie killer for me, you know what I'm saying? This is the same thing, Tavor X95. I got it tricked out, though, like, with the, got a meat probe up here. I got a 45. You know what I'm saying? So you can hit like this. I got 240 round mags stuck together. My foregrip got a light. And it's turned to a bipod. Boom. You know what I'm saying? Stand that mug up. The kickstand.
Stand the foot.
Yeah. When I get, when I have to get down in the bushes, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Real dirty with it. Cool. I'ma lay on it a little bit, see what I can do. I'ma lay on it.
It's your boy Rob Kaiser. Make sure y'all tune into my interview with Tubby and Keeping It Real at antidote.com. You dig? Or she bow, kicking it with Tubby. She told me that at the end of the interview. Anyway, follow me, social media, my Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, all of it is the same. Rob Kaiser, R-O-B-K-A-Z-I. Bow like a dog and we out. You hear me?
Hey, welcome back, man. Welcome back. Hope you didn't miss us. We back, C Bazz Cast. Yeah, pay a couple little bills right quick. You know, bills are important. It's good to take care of, you know what I'm saying? You got your due.
Speaking of bills, I haven't paid mine yet.
Then you got your due. Then you got your late. You better come on and pay something. You better come on and do something.
I know. I give it to the very, I push them to their last, absolute last.
Oh, call. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Hey, got when they to. Like extension, yeah. I'm like, extension me, please.
Yes, 11:59 p.m.
And then, the extension, I'm gonna even push you further. Yeah. And give me 3 more days out the extension, I'm gonna take 3 more days.
See, there's no confusion.
I'm just not paying. If I
why Kelsey B
year,
is on the show.
Extension.
It's the
like,
way to live.
I'm gonna just go, who the fuck wanna pay bills? I don't wanna pay no goddamn bills.
But now that she's with
all
Credit Stars, she's not doing that no
stars.
More.
You see how I'm living? I got the mink.
She got the mink. She had to come out that mink. That's
that
real mink.
Gonna make you think. Real mink. I ain't lying. It get hot as a mink.
What you said, the mink will make you think?
Mink will make you think about your life. You get so hot. I grew up hot. I never want to be hot again. I was a real hood baby. My daddy didn't never turn down.
Oh, man. Oh, I know.
I had to stick my head out the window for air.
My grandmother in Arkansas, man, they just keep the heater on. They got one of the heaters in the wall.
I hate to say they.
They don't wall heaters? Yeah. Yeah. You pull whatever you want to.
You
if you want to.
House you like,
burn your
I
whole left side
day.
Of your body off over there. Over there. Get some Vaseline on
one
it.
One day that bitch gonna catch a sweater.
Vaseline and cocoa
gonna
butter.
Be crazy.
All right, look, without further ado, we're gonna call up our guest, because we're supposed to come back with the guest. We'll call up our guest again. Business spotlight of the week, of the episode. Fred Sargent of emediagc.com.
Oh,
come on up. Come on up. He likes to make an entrance. He likes to make it in. Hey, what up, Fred? What up, Fred? Have a seat.
The stamina wouldn't have been the same getting on the stage.
So, there you go. Welcome, brother Fred Sargent.
Brother Fred. Get the mic on. There we go.
The jean suit top combo.
Oh my goodness. Appreciate you.
I feel like he knew he was gonna be sitting down.
Kelsey, he's layered.
He knew he was gonna be sitting down.
His mom will be proud. My baby layered on TV.
He layered.
My baby's layered.
That's how all my relatives dress at a funeral.
And y'all don't really say a home going.
Yes.
Celebration. Y'all just say funeral.
Yes. You look good, man. You got the pin on. Is that an immediate pin or just a pin?
No. This is actually a pin from one of our clients.
Okay, awesome. Okay.
LA Films.
Okay, LA Film. Okay, shout out to LA Film.
Yes, sir.
Louisiana Film Channel, right?
Yes, sir.
Shout out to Louisiana Film Channel. That's what's up. We coming for you. I said it here on the air. Anyway, welcome, friend. We appreciate you being here. That was glass breaking, but don't worry about it. We're going to stay focused right here, okay? We
care about you guys.
Somebody did something, but we're here. So, welcome. As you can see, he's one of our sponsors, the E up there.
Yes.
EMediaGC.com, Target Marketing and Distribution.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So, could you just tell us about that? What is Target Marketing? What is distribution?
All right.
I know, but I may not.
Okay, well, we do email marketing. Email marketing, we have databases throughout the Gulf Coast. Over 118 different cities catering to 4.7 million people. Woo. And we can submit your flyers and information to these guys with links back to your websites, videos, and things of that nature. So we work a lot with artists. We work a lot with businesses. Our main focus is probably concerts. That's our biggest thing, a lot of concerts and events.
Right, that's what I was going to say. So for the people in the Baton Rouge area, primarily, he's the street team for, like, Boots and Bash. He's street team for a concert I have coming up.
Oh, 10-4.
Which is awesome. February 27th, if you haven't heard about it, you will. Kings River Center.
So when we get that message, be saying Boots and Bash in the area,
right?
Such and such. That's you, Free.
Yes, man.
And I was
That's him. That's immediate. They reach you through, mainly email and text blasting.
Email and cell phone. We also do the street teams, like you said, with the walking billboards, mobile trucks. We have drones that we fly. We have you might see an airplane every blue moon.
Right.
So we do quite a few different things.
Nice.
And we do a lot of creative marketing concepts.
Right.
Consulting is our main job, is to educate and help with how to develop and do some creative things. So.
Right.
That's what we try to focus on. Okay. But the street teams, the walking billboards, the email campaigns, the cell phone campaigns.
Awesome.
That's the bread and butter.
Well, the main thing that I want to definitely speak on is every sponsor that you guys see on the screen, these are people and that I've used before personally. I like that organic feel. I just don't want to put businesses on. Don't worry, we'll take your money. I like money. But it's more of organic feel. I want to put companies on that I trust, that I've used, that have worked for me. And eMedia is truly one of them. I have to shout you guys out. You guys have done, I've been working with you guys now for about a year. I want to say about a year. And I want to encourage all artists, comedians, rappers, poets, anyone that has especially a product that you need to push and things you want to get out to 4.7 million subscribers. He's not lying. So it's helped my career out a lot with my comedy special and things like that. So thank you so much. And I want to encourage you guys because it's not the popular way. It's not the get on TikTok, you're going to buy everything, life change. No. You know, it's going directly to your email and blasting and, you know, text messages. You're going to see that. So I like that fact. The visibility of it is so big.
Yeah. See the emails, the cell phones, we definitely think that's a hot way. But I'm going to tell you, my favorite is actually the street teams.
Street team. Take it to the streets.
Yeah. Well, we get to actually shake hands, touch bases with people. With these walking billboards, they light up. We have one over in the corner over here, but
nice.
I mean, it
do
light up. It has GPS.
Can we get that on camera? Get it on camera?
They do like
the board, is that okay?
Yeah.
Can we get that?
Yeah, they actually can.
I want my business advertised, but I want them to do like a headspin, a handstand, like some turbo.
They can do some creative stuff. I don't know about that. We do play games. We have some interactive games that they play on the billboards.
Right.
Like Booster Game is basketball.
And so we'll have him playing a little basketball and stuff. He loved that game. But we have quite a few for like restaurants and stuff like that, where you throw the little target, you might win a prize. And all this is on a billboard that's mobile and able to move around. And so it's great for, we do a lot of marathons. We do a lot of like the River Center and those type events. My God, interactive intersections, what we call it. That's really big for us, where we actually get the guys right out on the main highway.
I saw that. Yeah, so
yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. We have guys, wherever you need them at, especially like for LSU games, Southern University games.
Right.
We'll put those guys right there across the hump.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And
it's good
visibility.
It's good for Southern fans to be able to see a light up billboard when they're leaving the game, especially after they play Grambling, because they normally lose. So it gives them something to really cheer about and be excited about when they leave it. And like, we lost the game, but you know what? There's a light up billboard.
Right.
That's cool.
You know, Seabass, I actually went to Cracker Grambling. That's where I went.
Louisiana Tech.
I'm a proud Louisiana Tech grambling.
What was your major?
Electrical engineering, and I was so fucking
basic
terrible.
As fuck.
I was the worst engineer on
you
the planet.
You basic AM.
That's why I love. I'm like, Dad, how you feel about me having like a 4-year degree and then I just do comedy?
Right.
Awesome. It's great.
What degree
yeah.
you got, C-Bass?
It's great, huh?
You got a degree?
Yeah, I got a degree, girl.
In what?
Environmental science.
You think the biology? But what was you going to?
My plan. So when I had first got
what
there,
what was that for? Because I don't see the beauty.
Environmental
in.
Science.
Yeah.
The environment. COVID.
Oh yeah, that's a good plan. Okay. Yeah.
If I would have been, I messed up. I didn't mess up. I'm sorry, America.
You was getting real passionate about it. I feel like you may be missing out on your calling. Maybe
I apologize.
Be an environmental scientist.
Yeah, because. I could have saved us
from
the COVID thing.
Close. That's what I heard.
He was about to get real political. And you know what about the dirt and the soil?
Yes. Take care of Mother Earth, man. That's why all these
Mother Earth
variants coming out.
Women are Mother Earth. So long as you take care of yourself as a woman.
Take care of yourself as a woman.
Take care of Mother Earth.
Take care of Mother Earth. Don't throw the bottle on the ground.
Put it in a trash bin.
Put the trash can. What else can we do? What else? What else is there? Don't get gas all the time. Get gas some of the time.
Get an electric car.
Get an electric car. What else?
Go to Credit Stars, get your credit done, and then get an electric car. That's what I plan to do. And then I want to go to Intelligent Mortgage and get like a $500,000 house, even though I can't afford it.
There you go.
Hey, fake it till you make it.
There you go.
Hey, if my credit gets good enough, it won't matter how much money I have.
That's right.
It's the thought that counts with credit, man. And
that's
you
right.
thought about your credit,
that's
you're
right.
doing something with yourself.
Yep.
Okay?
Change
lives. And
that's
how the housing crisis started in 2008. Right there. You just got to believe in yourself, man.
You just got to believe in yourself. As soon as you get like
you're
a 680, get a
telling me you make $8,000 a month.
You can't afford it.
It's all good.
Doesn't
so,
matter.
Yeah. But back to E-Media. So again, so we thank you so much for just stopping by, coming on here with us, man.
I appreciate it.
It means a lot for us. And so just give us a little bit of background. Like, I mean, I know we talked about most like the front surface stuff, but how did you even get into E-Media? What was the concept behind it? Because, you know, again, it's kind of a niche thing. Most people are looking at like TV or radio. So how did you kind of find that niche in E-Media?
Well, actually, I've been in business now, man, 30 years, over 30 Ooh, years now.
30, yeah, and, 30.
Yeah, 30. So actually what
happened. I was a negative
is,
one when y'all started. Me and Kelsey the same, man. We both 29. I wasn't even born yet, America.
Oh, goodness. Somebody telling the tale.
I wasn't.
what? He had already
somebody
graduated.
Lied.
He went to Grambling already.
But no, man, what actually happened, man, is that we started off doing Rolodexes.
Okay, I remember the Rolodex. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, well, we would actually collect data, their phone numbers,
oh, wow.
and stuff like that. And so it evolved and got digital on us. And so we just kept expanding that Rolodex. And basically now we just have a digital Rolodex.
So y'all think nice. Those people got them same numbers from 1992?
Well, that's why you got to always
do.
Update.
Had to do. And,
well,
and,
you got to update everything. You can't just stick with them same contact information.
Now, if she was an old hoe,
oh goodness,
she got that goddamn number.
Oh goodness. Well,
and
I don't know about that.
Had to get them meter. Had it in sync that the booster bash came about and had it like, God damn it, I'm here. I seen I got the booster bash on me.
Booster Bash is big for me. I got 2 gigs out the Booster Bash with the walking billboard. It was awesome.
Okay. You got what?
I got 2 gigs from the walking billboards at the Booster Bash.
Oh, damn.
Yeah,
well,
it was nice.
Well, see, but that's the thing, man. A lot of people, we show them how to quantify that stuff, how to actually track what they're doing.
Right.
Because a lot of people, they do marketing, promotion. They instead of spending money, investing money, but they don't know how to track it. They don't know, can't quantify the success of it.
See,
and so that's a big thing for us, man.
That's the big part I want to point out. So basically, a lot of us create, right? Like, especially during COVID. Let's think about that for a second. During COVID, everyone started a business. Everybody did.
Everyone had
an
LLC because they were trying to get PPP.
I was an accountant, but now I sell eyelashes. Like, everybody found a business.
They found it.
But this is the thing, though.
They didn't find
it. Once you create that business,
that's why
how you need media GC to drive people to your business.
I saw Brianna's balloons.
That's the most important part. You know, that's what I want to really get across, because so many folks will build something, but then guess what? You don't know what to do with it once you do that.
Well, that's when I think the consultations come in.
Yeah.
Where we actually consult with them and walk with them through the
process.
Oh,
y'all consult?
Absolutely.
Yeah, we have to. Because a lot of people really, they're getting the things like, I know a lot of guys who have like restaurants and barbershops and like that.
Tell them about,
they know how to cut hair.
Tell them about when I first called you. What was the conversation like? It was a problem. I want all the streets filled with C Bazz. I want a building designated like on Avengers with Tony Stark.
Like y'all talking. You want the
planes.
Whole side of a building.
I had no idea what I was talking about. I was like, I want all the radio stations. Like, so he had like, hey, calm down. You know, so just tell him. You can tell him, Fred, it's okay. It's all right.
Well, it's pretty easy, man. The first thing we do is we consider ourselves to be like marketing doctors. Okay, so we'll give you a prescription.
Marketing doctors.
Yeah, we'll give you a prescription, you know what I mean? And so in order to get that prescription, we have to ask you a couple of questions.
Okay.
One of them is the really big one that people are really afraid of. I'm going to start off with that, is a budget, you know?
Right.
Your budget.
You got a budget.
Well, your budget to the doctor is like your insurance, you know? And that's where a lot of people, man, they really get a little nervous when you talk about that budget. And so, but we have to talk about that.
Right.
And then we're going to ask other questions. If we ask you the right questions and we take our time and consult with you, we can actually find out what problem you have. Some people say, hey, look, I got a headache. I need to amputate my arm. That's not what you need to do. Okay?
Y'all
you don't
sounded
need
like
to
real
do
doctors.
That. So we actually have to sit back and deal with you.
I ain't got no Medicaid. Can I come to you?
You know? And see that's what we do. See, at that time, we say, hey, look, you take 2 aspirin, call me in the morning, because you don't have the right insurance. You don't have enough insurance. And nothing's wrong with that. We try to work with you. Nah, not at all.
You going to fix them up.
Yeah, we're going to try. We're going to give you a Tylenol until you call us in the morning. You know what I mean?
Break pants and
we'll give it a shot.
Back.
Yeah, we'll give it a shot.
They put business on their back, literally. Well,
yeah, literally.
Yeah, they do.
Literally.
Yeah.
Literally.
I wish you could have brought one of your people with you and had them. Maybe we'll do another episode, but actually
actually have someone who would do it. But
really? Here right now?
We thought we were just going to be focused right here, so we didn't want to.
Are they here right now?
You know. Oh, yeah.
Can they come up and put the sign in back right now?
I don't know if she want to.
Can they do? Oh, wait. We got someone that, okay.
Yeah,
we got
an
immediate representative.
Yeah, lady, she's
COVID friendly. She has the mask on.
Because
she ain't about no foolishness.
Is she licensed on the back side?
Yes, so if you can put the board on, you can literally come right here. Put the board on right here. We're going for everybody to see.
You need help, lady?
Yeah, go.
Bring it
over here.
The backs of others.
And it's not, okay, now, showing you right there, it's not even heavy.
Media.
Not even heavy. It looks very light.
Oh, and they got the scammy codes. They can make you a code. Y'all make that code?
Okay, so we're doing this right on TV, y'all. Just snapping it,
whoop
snapping it,
it
on.
Whoop it, whoop.
Oh, look at that. Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Cool.
Actually,
we have your spring 2022.
Nice.
Place your ad here, billboard. She's rocking the boots with the balls at the back.
Balls
she's
at the back.
She's giving me ponytail fashion.
Yes.
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 I'll tell you something, man.
Yes.
See the QR code on the back?
Yes.
We provide free QR codes.
Nice.
We know that right now tech is where you kind of want to, you know, go with the technological advances.
Absolutely.
And, but
go
one
ahead
of
the
things, too, is that
on the
it's
camera.
Only
yeah,
about
yeah,
8
put
pounds.
Put it on
the camera.
Yeah.
You know?
Awesome. Yeah,
this
nice.
Is a
you
book
might
sack
not
that's
think
only
you
about
need
8
it.
Pounds.
Awesome.
You know, you can't
but you better
that.
Receive
it.
It
lights
right.
up. I don't know if you guys could tell
See
with
media,
all the lights,
baby.
But it lights up. We're taking over for the 99 and 2000. Webcams. I love it. Taking pictures and video.
I love
webcams.
It.
So, yeah, y'all get a little kinky. Actually, quite I love a bit it. Of tech inside the board. You know?
No, it's all, and now I'm going to say this. You guys are at a lot of outdoor events, right? So oh, yes, tell sir. The people, yes, on average in a year, in Baton Rouge alone, okay, how many outdoor events are there?
Man, before COVID actually happened, you have over 1,000 events in the downtown Baton Rouge area.
Thank you.
In the downtown Baton Rouge.
You able to get and so, good? Okay, all right. Because quarters, we hadn't worked out at the ground. We hadn't worked out the, okay, thank you. Awesome. All right. See, round actually, of applause. Round of applause. For the,
thank you, Lady. Thank
we
you.
Hadn't worked out the fall situation yet. Which,
we don't have insurance on the show yet.
We hadn't worked that out yet.
You had to work it out? Yeah.
Capital
Y. We do have good credit.
First and last episode. No. That was fun.
Working on it.
Oh, yeah. That was We do.
But no, I'm sorry. But I didn't mean to cut you off.
I think you were saying
we were talking about the board. It was some of the outdoor events, right? Before COVID.
Before COVID, you actually had over 1,000 events in the downtown Baton Rouge area.
Right.
That wasn't including the clubs and the other things that's kind of popping off.
Right.
So, awesome. It's so much activity here. The streets, we actually work with DOT, and we get the numbers for the busy intersections.
Nice.
So if you actually want to put a board on that intersection, we could actually tell you how many people pass that intersection, how many eyeballs, as they call it, pass that intersection.
See, that's something I never would have known. You just like, go out there and market for me. Where, though? You know, you got to know the hot spots, right?
Yes.
Like, I know one.
Yes, that's a big
one. I know where the people at.
I know one is the corner of North Foster where that man be at all the time with the radio.
Yep.
Everybody, the fruit man.
That's Plank Road.
Do you work with him?
Yeah.
Plank Road.
He actually carried
it. It ain't just bad stuff on Plank Road.
I've never seen him have a billboard.
No, he got a flag on his back. See, that's a smaller version of that.
No.
This is on.
Not him. Y'all need to go get that man a job because he's always out there.
Well, I don't know. I don't think he mentally all the way there. You know? So I gotta watch him. I know who you're talking about.
And mentally, y'all need to give him a job.
I don't know about him.
Because he's standing there with a billboard on his back.
Well, we got some guys that's like on, for instance, Airline Highway in Greenwell Spring.
That's a big intersection.
Yeah, very big intersection. The guy be selling fruit and stuff. And
no,
so, yeah, that's one of our guys.
He been out there for like 20 years.
Yes, no doubt.
I was a baby when I first saw him.
No doubt.
And he still like the same.
And he moved. He actually moved around. So he go to Evangeline and stuff. Yeah, Evangeline Plank Road.
That man been out there a long time. It must be worth it.
Oh, man. Yeah, it's worth it.
See, man, he been out there a long time.
No, he killing the game low-key, though. On the low, he killing the game.
And I've seen big businesses like the Hidden Vault.
Yep.
The sex products and stuff. Like, I've seen him with their billboards. So,
concerts,
obviously,
like that,
y'all are doing some numbers.
Oh, yeah.
Because big brands
are
still advertising with the walking billboard.
Man, we work with from McDonald's to Raising Cane's, Walmart's. Oh, my goodness. We have so many sponsors. So many people.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. We, like I say, we've been doing it
forever,
man.
You ain't wearing
a
suit jacket for nothing.
Yeah, and my website. They got my website
on there. The River
Centers.
That's right. Down in New Orleans, oh my God.
Superdome.
Oh my goodness.
Well, I'm sorry,
we
what is
stay
it
so
now?
Busy.
Mercedes yeah.
It's called a Mercedes Benz Superdome.
It's something else now.
Caesar's.
Caesar. Okay, yeah, Caesar's stepped up. Yeah.
I'm so sick of looking at Jimmy's.
We haven't got them yet.
That shit, bro. I ain't gonna.
Yeah,
come
we haven't
on
got them
get
yet.
Like, what are you talking about? Yeah, what are you talking
hey,
about?
Hey, bro, go to sleep.
Yeah. And my website, emediagc.com/cbazz, where you can see all my events, comedy special, everything. So, yeah. So I rock with E-Media, man. I'm glad, again, you came.
Oh, man, appreciate you, man.
No,
appreciate
no problem,
you,
man. Thank you, man, for just coming on. I think so many people need this service. I really do. And I feel like so many people are kind of missing the ball, and they're not able to really grow in the market like they should. And I feel like your service could be a much easier way for them, you know?
Well, I think so, and I think it's cost-effective.
Absolutely.
I used to sell radio and television. And so it's a quick myth. I want to try to bust this myth, is that you really do not have to do some of the things that we used to say, like with radio, is all about frequency, you know? Well, with the type of marketing we do, it's not about frequency as much.
Right.
To give you a really quick example, so I can get on out of here, but a real quick example, if I come to the to your Christmas ball, and I bring my wife with me, and I have on red, she have on white, and we doing a little twirl, and we look like a candy cane, and we really making things happen. Okay, we looking good.
Right.
See, next year, all your people going to ask, hey, where's those guys that was doing that?
Right.
See, we didn't have to do that every day, five times a day. We did it one time. We did it very well. What we do with electronic media. We market you very well the first time so you don't have to keep on doing it.
That's good. That's good. And so much so that we're doing a production next week. It's actually going to be called the Comedy Corner, where we're going to use the platform to showcase some of the areas like good, like great comedians or up-and-coming comedians. And they'll be going out weekly. Kelsey will be there. Mr. West Ross will be featured on it. So that'll be great through eMedia. So check out eMediaCity.com.
And one more thing. Yes. Because I know you're going to forget about it. I know you're going to forget
about it. I always forget
stuff. What about Sundays?
Sundays.
We're working with you. On the comedy program you're doing on Sundays.
Yes. Sunday Fun Days. We're here at the Grind every Sunday doing comedy. And we're working on some great innovative things using eMedia with our vendor tables and sponsors and different things. So it's
we're
awesome.
Calling it the Who's Who.
That right
program.
There it is right there.
Yeah.
Sunday. I didn't give them the Who's Who. But I'll give
that?
It to them next week.
Yeah, that's just with the business.
Yeah, it's so much. Yeah, sorry. But but we're excited to have you, and we're gonna go ahead and close out with a commercial break. And we'll be right back after this, man. Shout out to Fred Sargent, West Falls, Kelsey.
Thank you guys.
Did you want to see myself? And we at the Grind. We'll be right back.
Hey guys, what's going on? It's your girl Tubby of the Nerdy Burger Site and Antidote.com. I have an opportunity to bring you all the new exclusive information you need to know about the Antidote Network. You guys, this year we're bringing you a host of new content. Some of your favorite shows have new episodes, including Just Landed, I've Got Drank, Pressure, Kicking the Real, and Hella High, and so much more. We have new podcasts coming, a new fashion segment, as well as more sports and entertainment for you guys. We'll be in the field more, covering more live events and more. You guys don't want to miss it. Make sure that you are downloading our channel directly to your Roku, Apple TV, and Fire Stick, as well as subscribing to our YouTube channel and checking us out directly on theantidote.com. Anything that's culturally rich that can be supported within your community and beyond, The Antidote has it covered. Make sure you support who's supporting you. Bye, guys.
Thank y'all for tuning in. I just want to let you know about my show called I Got Drank. Everybody know me as I Got Tracks, you know, producer, writer, singer, rapper, whatever you want to call me. I just make music and stuff for fun. But I also drink these drinks. Make sure y'all tune in and check this shit out. Shit, fire.
Those are burnt.
Welcome to Centurion Car Care, located at 11857 Florida Boulevard, where we do quality work at an affordable price. We also do paint and body, exhaust work, and any minor and major mechanic work. Best mechanic shop south of the Mississippi.
Hey everybody, it's your girl T-Lynn with The Antidote and I Got Drink. Make sure you guys follow us for the new year. We have so much exciting things coming for you guys. So make sure you're following the host, I Got Tracks, and me, of course, XOXO underscore you are as truly, and also The Antidote on all the social media platforms and all the streaming platforms. See you next year. Bye.
what's going on? It's your girl Tubby of Kicking the Real, exclusively found here on theantidote.com and the Antidote Network. If you are looking for an opportunity to come and sit down and actually kick the real with me, it's a couple of things that you have to do. Very simple. First off, start by sending an email with your interest over to eric@antidote.com or candace@antidote.com. From there, follow up and respond. They'll get you scheduled and we'll get you in. Make sure in the meantime that you're actually following The Antidote on all social media platforms and that you're subscribed to our YouTube channel. Also, follow me so I know to be looking for you coming into your interview days. You guys, I'm looking forward to having you join me to tell your stories and to show the rest of the world exactly why you do what you do and why you're so passionate about it. Make sure you take the opportunity to get the info submitted so that you have a chance to come and kick the real with me. Bye.
Mm-hmm. You know what I got on? I got that Veil Life get on. If you don't have that Veil Life get on and you're not on life, you're dead out here. Wake up. Don't sleep. You're fresh. Veil Life just a comedy group. Don't be foolish.
All right. You see the cast walking back across the screen. Just how we planned it. Welcome back to the C Bazz Cast. You know the cast, we're here, we're having a good time. We just have to take a moment introduce our very, very special guest for this episode, Mr. Eugene Collins. Now, Eugene is smooth, so you might be guessing model, ambassador. But you know it's something, going on here. You don't know what, but I tell you what. He is the president of the Baton Rouge chapter of the NAACP, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome.
Man, appreciate you having me, C-Bass. It's great to sit here with y'all.
No, thank you, man. Thank you for being here. I know, again, we've been trying to get you for a little while. You just came fresh off a panel with Gary Chambers, Dadrius, Myra. Who else was it, man? Everybody. Jesus. Who else? Everybody was there, man.
It was all black.
It was crazy.
That sounded like all black crowd.
Well, it was. They had a few state legislators there.
Yes.
As well as Mr. Chambers, Mr. Walter Gino McLaughlin.
Yes, Gino.
A few community activists. It was a great thing. We were talking about redistricting and the voting process that's approaching us.
Yes, that's big. That's big. I mean, it's all about outreach. Sharing the word, getting us right. Thank you for getting us right, okay? We need it. We need leadership in the community. So I thank you for playing that role. And you've been doing literally so much, man. Especially, I would say, definitely what I've noticed over, like, the past couple of years. I mean, like, literally boots on the ground, from out in Sterling, from just George Floyd, from just everything, man. So just tell us, like, about your involvement, some of the things you've been doing, and just brings up the speed a little bit with what's going on.
So we have some of our members that are sitting out here today as well.
Awesome.
But our organization took the lead on the Ronald Green case in state police.
Yes.
We also took the lead on Donald Trump and Robinson. We also took the lead on the 700 cases that was dropped as a part of police corruption, and our hero Jeremiah Arwin that stepped out. We took the lead on that case as well. So our branch has been really active for justice.
Yes.
We always tell folks, either you go do right by our people, or we're gonna knock your ass out the way.
There you go. There it is. I see you feel the aggression and the power in that. I hope you do. I hope you feel that. But I think it's time. I think so many of us just talk about, like, what are we gonna do. Have us on a what to do. I'll tell you, I had my taste of protesting. I had just kind of came back into the area when out in Sterling, the situation that happened, and I actually was in Miami. I was doing a show in Miami. I saw it, and then literally a day later, I was in the airport, and I saw the murder of Philando Castile. And when I saw that, it just enraged me. I never felt that before. I'm a comedian. I'm very lighthearted. I never felt it before like that. So I got here, and I hopped on the front line. Shout out to my hometown homegirl, Quayla. She picked me up. We was, like, out there. We was actually on the in the intersection of right by the Baton Rouge Police, like, right there on Goodwood and Airline. We were there, and I was ready, but I had never done it before. I had heard about it. Never done it. And, was on the front line, it was real because I had to ask myself, am I ready to die at that moment? Because it got up real and they had, you know, use the sticks and, you know, the guns and somebody threw a water bottle from the back and I'm the biggest dude on the front line. It was real scary for me, seriously. But I was there though. So you can't say I wasn't there. But then I started thinking about like my daughter. I started thinking about just, you know, other things going on. So I was not quite ready to kind of combat it like that. But the fact that you do it every day, the fact that you guys like walk the streets, you're out there in the community, like what's some of the impact you think you've had in just with all of this?
So one of the biggest things as you talk about this fight for justice, right?
Right, exactly.
It can't just be the police shootings, right? Because when we look at police shootings, sometimes we mistake justice for accountability.
Right.
If you send somebody to jail, but you had a video of them being shot, that's not justice. That's accountability.
Right.
Justice only comes in the situations where cops show up and they see 50 witnesses and they never question anybody, but they still take somebody that looked like you and I to jail.
Right. Wow.
Getting justice on those cases,
yeah,
that's when we really see progress. And we're not really getting justice on those cases. And we talk about this all the time with respectability politics, right?
Right.
All of that talking nice and all of that stuff and saying what voters want to hear, that ain't never worked for nobody but the person sitting in the seat. Right. What we have to start to do is challenge the system. I don't want to sit at every table. Some rooms I walk in, I want to walk in and flip the tables over.
Right.
And that's what we got to get to as a sense of a people is that we're not going to accept second best. We want first. And if you don't give it to us, we're going to take
it. And we deserve it.
I like it. I love it.
We deserve it.
Thank you for that. You know, it seems like sometimes there's just a bit of a disconnect to me from NAACP, what you guys are doing and just like our youth, the real streets, and just regular everyday people that's kind of living our lives. So what are your thoughts on that?
So let me say this. I think there's a disconnect between our youth and us in general, not just the NAACP, right?
Right.
We're not reaching these kids. And a lot of that's because a kid is really honest, right? They gonna call what they see. If it walk like a duck, yep, it quack like a duck, it's a duck.
It's a duck, yep. Yeah.
That's the reality. Some of us have been around here play Jenkins for so long,
right,
and these kids are calling
I
us
love
out
that
on our bullshit.
Love it. Yeah.
That's what it is. That's why these kids won't listen to us, because
right,
we fake.
Right. No, I love it. I used to say fake Jenkins a lot. I love that term.
I say pump faking. I don't know where it comes from.
Pump faking, right.
Y'all be pump faking.
Yeah. Well, what led you?
That's
you call it fibbing.
Yeah.
So what led you to this journey to becoming the president of the BR chapter? Like what? Like okay, we got Eugene. Were you like, you know, 5-year-old Eugene? Like we're not gonna take this. You're gonna give us our milk. You know what? How
right,
did
like
you know what?
Is.
You just, you're tired of. I want real food in the like, school system, and you started a ride. Like what story? What kind of got you along this path?
Right.
So I was raised two houses down from Reverend Mary Moody, which was one of the
wow,
historical civil rights leaders of this town. She was yes, my neighbor, right? So it was hard not to get involved. And I was raised by a powerful black man
yeah,
that
hello,
would not take no for an answer.
Hello.
So when you come from that, there was no other reason. And I'll tell you this. I never wanted to be president. I was the organization lead advocate.
Okay.
And I was the organization's investigator.
Right.
And those are two things you hadn't saw in this role in a very long time.
Right.
Because typically the president's more reserved, way more polished,
yes,
up in a shirt and tie, right?
Yeah.
So I never wanted to be president. I actually wanted to stay the organization's investigator.
Nice.
But what came about is that nobody wanted to be president.
Right.
So I was kind of next up.
Wow.
Yeah.
So you just kind of got it by default, basically. It was
default,
like, it was kind of like it's here for you.
Default.
And you
were just
up,
your concerned self.
Yeah, it was.
Do y'all vote on it? What's the process?
Just be
like,
yourself. You never know.
Do you have to have a fist fight to get presidency of NAACP? Or do you have to recite Martin Luther King's speech?
No.
Backwards. What do you have to do to get become president of something like this? What do you got to do?
So we're duly elected by our members, and this is I'm going into my third term. And
nice,
you know, that's crazy to me because I tell you, I never wanted to be president. I wanted to fill in until we found the
yeah,
guy that actually wanted to do this.
Wow,
I wanted
yeah,
to be the guy that's on the front line,
right?
Making sure that our people get justice, making
yeah,
sure that the folks that normally don't get wins.
Right.
I never wanted to sit behind a desk.
Yeah.
So as president, I decided that I just wasn't going to sit behind a desk at all.
Right.
And it's worked out. And
awesome,
that's the beauty of this organization is that it's ours.
Yes.
If you see something and you don't like what the NAACP is doing, come tell us. Now I'm gonna put you to work when you come.
Right.
If you ain't coming to work, don't
right,
come.
Don't come at all.
Come
to work.
Yeah.
But it's gotta be about that. It's gotta
yeah,
be about pushing this thing forward, and not just with justice. When we talk about justice, I don't give a damn if you take my boy in a uniform, in all black, or laced with a fentanyl pill. You are an enemy of mine.
Yes.
And we got to start to think that. We got to take our streets back. We got to save our young men. And I specifically say our young men because our young women are out here killing each other. It's our young men. We need to speak specifically to the problem. Right. And we got to reach them, and they ain't listening to nobody. We keep talking about the OGs. Where they at?
Right. Right.
OGs ain't got no experience.
I mean, you know, I appreciate you for saying that. I mean, one of the reasons, and I feel greatly moved by the Ando Network, you know, they reach, I think, a lot of the streets. They reach a lot of the youth. They're a very cool network, a lot of great things going on. So hopefully by you coming on, they can see this. You know, they can kind of hear this. Because with our show, we're always full of comedy and laughs. But, you know, I'm watching social media all day, every day. You know, that's how I was able to see so much of just what you've been doing and what you have done and what you continue to do, to where I'm just kind of like, okay, I cannot ignore, you know, issues. I can't sit back and ignore the violence. I can't sit back and ignore. I live in this community too.
Right.
You know, I'm a father. You know, I'm a husband, things like that. So just, again, for you to come forward and speak on it, it means so much. And I agree with you. There has to be some way where we can stop the things that we're doing to each other. And it has to happen fast.
We have to get to the youth.
And let me say this. The youth ain't the problem. We the problem.
Right.
Because in my house, my son gonna do what I say do.
Yeah.
My daughter's gonna listen to my instructions. Yep. If they don't, that's your problem, right?
Yeah, I'm about to do something right now. I feel the power. They not listening.
The parents are younger and younger.
Yeah.
And our youth aren't the problem. We suck.
Right.
Youth ain't change. We change. Wow. Our systems change.
Right.
Once upon a time, you walked in a neighborhood, anybody could give you instruction.
Sure could.
Now you got to worry about getting shot.
Yeah.
That's true. So the youth aren't the problem. The youth ain't doing nothing different than they did 60 years ago. Parents suck. Adults suck. Mm-hmm. Neighborhoods suck.
Not the youth.
Don't blame the youth anymore, based on what you're saying.
Why would you blame the youth for something they didn't create?
Right.
You sucked. And you created this problem that your youth walked into. This didn't happen overnight.
You let it do what it want to do.
Yeah, you don't blame the youth for what you created.
Now, you know, what I hear a lot, and this is just kind of, I think, kind of going back to, I think, leadership, maybe back to the protesting side of things. I want you to ask a question for me. And this is just me. This is not even anything I talk about with the cast. This is not, you know, this is just what I want to ask you. So when it comes to, like, protesting, I always hear a lot of our people say, like, they ain't going to do nothing. They walk into the Capitol steps, and they ain't going to do nothing. And it ain't. They just walk in. They just exercising,
like,
really.
What can you do?
And I've heard that, you know, so many times. And, you know, I've had my opinions on it as well. But I would love to hear what you have to say to that.
So, Ms. April White, one of our organizational attorneys, is
Shout
sitting right
April.
There.
Shout out to April.
April, how many protests have you been to?
How many protests, April?
Too many to count.
At least three, right?
At least three,
so
okay.
So we're talking about three over my three terms, right?
Right.
So I don't believe in protesting all the time.
Right.
Because if you protest and you're not putting pressure on a specific point, it's not doing any good. If you don't have a legislator in the building working for you, it's not doing any good. The biggest thing I hate about protests is it's become tomfoolery of folks just going down there in front of buildings taking pictures with no purpose. And I call that crap
pictures
out.
Because
let's think about this for a second. You want to have a march on a Saturday, right? What kind of protest is on a Saturday? What are you disrupting with businesses are closed?
Right.
So why are you marching on a Saturday? That makes no sense.
Right.
And we got to call that crap out.
Yeah.
When you see the NAACP moving, or when you see us taking action, or you see us protesting, pay attention, because it's something real.
Yes.
And if it ain't real, we ain't going to do it. So,
that's
no,
what I'm talking about.
I ain't with that taking pictures and doing all the social media videos and all that crap either. That's some fake stuff. Most folks just out here playing dress up.
See,
and that's the real side of it.
That's okay. Thank you for clearing it up for me, because
for me too.
It seems to be like, just, you know, looking at history, it seemed to be where, when black people had an issue, when something was wrong, it was NAACP. Now it's just like you got so many different things going on, to where it's not like, it's almost like the NAACP is somewhat kind of been forgotten about some. You know what I mean?
But you know what? We like that, right? Because when we talk about these other elements, right? And I'm going to issue this out. Black Lives Matter, right?
Right.
Where they office at? What they do? When the last time they showed up and talked to your kids?
They had painted, paint across the street from the White House. What was
that? Exactly.
they did some nice artwork. It's okay.
Nice
gotta give it up. I mean, the letters were all together and it looked nice. And
I didn't see the footwork necessarily, but somebody was on their knees painting.
It's a hashtag.
Right.
It's a hashtag.
It's a hashtag, yeah.
We got to start blaming ourselves for the clowns that we follow.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying? We followed that clown.
Right.
Like, why get disappointed because you decided to follow a clown?
Right.
The NAACP, where we at, we ain't on the protest line, but we in court.
Yes.
She's down at the public defender's office making sure that people that can't afford equitable legal services getting somebody competent. Wow. That's where we are. But if we decide to follow clowns, we shouldn't judge them.
Right.
We might be in the clown circle with them.
Hello.
Hello, Vico.
Yeah. I mean, I appreciate it, man. I've been on the site. I've been looking. The site's very nice, by the way. Everything's very clear and very together. So, you know, what are some of the initiatives that you all would like to see the community do as far as support or the viewers that may be watching? What are some of the things that we can help and join in the fight that for the people that don't know or the people that might see what you're doing and feel moved? I'm thankful that I had a platform to where I can say, hey, come on the show. Not everybody has a show.
Let's
so
talk
what,
about it.
Yeah, what are some of the things that, you know, you would like to see in our people kind of do, and what the white people do. You know, Wes is white, clearly.
Love the girl point.
We got
the people see it. He's white. We're
we
not gonna hide.
I Wes been real quiet.
TV, he's right
get
there.
Wes in here.
He's white, but he's not racist.
What can my
I think.
Do?
No, I'm joking. He's
I'm
really
on the C Bazz Cast.
Yeah, he's a comedian. He's a great, great guy, but. What are some of the things that you would like to see us kind of do?
Well, I'm going to tell you, even with Wes, man, our allies are important, right?
Right.
Yep. Because you can go some places and say some stuff that if I said, they're going to tow me out of there.
Right.
That's just your privilege, right?
Right.
Now, when we talk about what we can do to help, right?
Right.
That's why I keep my mouth shut.
Now, there's never a shortage of people that want to go to the press conference. There's never a shortage of people that want to march. The shortage of folks always comes down to the core work, the economic development stuff, the stop the violence stuff, the things that actually make a difference.
Right.
We need men in our organization, right? We need men to go and mentor these young boys.
They need men, Dre.
And we don't need women because women are showing up and working. Let's keep it real.
Right.
For
yeah,
a
the women was on the
women
when I was protesting, the women was right there. They was like, "What you gonna do?" And I was like, "Okay, I'm here, but I whoa." Like
I'm
they
not
was
as bold
together,
as you.
They was ready. Yeah. Way more the energy they brought. They was 10, I was like a 6.5.
Yeah. And they so powerful, right?
Like
yes.
Because
they
I
are.
Look at I look at my membership, right? And my membership is probably 70% female. And they show up and listen to their male president.
Right.
Right. And we wouldn't do the same, keep it real.
So I
look at the power in that. But unless we reach these young men, ain't nothing gonna change. Because guess what? We gotta go out and start telling these young men to go get a wife again and stop just looking for the person of the night.
Kill wife.
We got to go out and start telling these young women to look for a husband and not their next car note.
Right.
Like, until we rebuild the village,
yes.
None of this stuff will change. The village has to be rebuilt.
I love it. We just got away from it,
baby. That's their foundation.
I love it. So, speaking of finding a wife and everything, Eugene, you single? What you mad? What you doing? What you doing out here? You just working.
You just wearing soft.
Yeah, I mean he got a nice watch on. I mean nice shoes and you know it's
got
you know,
velvet on a suede. I don't know what this
know.
Is.
I'm gonna tell you not anytime. There's probably about 3 private investigators watching this, right?
Okay.
So that's why I kind of leave my personal stuff.
Okay.
Out
yeah,
of,
he's
a
man of purpose. All right. Don't worry about. Go get in his business.
Power.
I tell you what though. What you like to do for fun, Eugene?
No,
like, if you're not NAACP fighting for our rights. You know what are you? Are you watching? What do you do for fun? What do you do just on a regular day?
Man, so yeah, I'm gonna tell you, like literally, you know,
you
for fun, there's not a whole lot. I mean, you can ask my members here. If I wasn't here right now, I'd probably be at the Alumni Center in my office.
Right.
Because this work never ends. I try to sneak on the golf course every now and then. I'm not very good at it.
Yeah.
Golf course.
Yeah, golf course.
I play golf too. Yeah.
Come on
okay,
out, man.
All right. Okay.
But y'all most of my. I
be playing some golf. I got my own golf clubs and everything.
Okay.
I be doing my thing.
Yeah, most of my fun consists playing with my boys, man.
That's awesome.
You know, I got a son that plays nose guard, big old boy. And
okay.
And I play with him and keep just playing with
Eugene's
my kids.
Very pure. He's very pure and he's fighting for our rights.
Yes.
I love him.
I love it. I love it. He's a man of people. So, Eugene, there's a little part of our show that we're at right now. It's called Lunchtime Loving, okay?
Now,
Listen, we respect you, brother. We're not going to do
y'all
anything.
Got the vocals, right?
All the music kicked in. I get smooth when the music comes in. I have to do something real quick. Apologize. Hey, guys, I got to do something real quick. Kelsey, just for a sec. Just for a sec. I got to do something. Shout out to the ladies.
To the ladies. All right.
Eugene's getting very uncomfortable, but it's okay. We're going
to
take care of
you. Ladies.
So it's a segment called Lunchtime Loving. And it's all about getting some loving at lunchtime. Now, look. You know, we have a lot of work to do. We got stuff we got to do. But at the same time, we just like to take a moment. Because if it wasn't for love, Eugene, neither one of us would be here. We just got to be honest about that, you know. Wouldn't happen. NAACP got NAACP babies. You know, let's not shy away. You said she a crack baby. It's okay. We're trying to fight against that. Now, what I'm saying is this, okay? Why don't you have a little fun with us, all right? Just a little fun, okay? The objective of this, Eugene, is to try and get some loving for lunchtime. That's it. That's your purpose. But you gotta set the mood, right?
You gotta have something.
And we do it in song, so we're gonna do it in 1, 2, 3.
Lunchtime loving for you. Shimmy the tweet, tweet, tweet.
All right. We're gonna do it again one more time. Cause I got some lemon pepper chicken in my throat. So shout out to Quarters. I got very good lemon pepper chicken. Do it again. One more time. You good? You straight? You got COVID out? Got a little COVID out? All right, good. Okay, so we do it again. One, two, three.
Lunchtime loving for you.
It's okay, Eugene. I ain't singing lunchtime loving. Anyway, so I'm just going to have you up here with us being uncomfortable, all right? I'm going to tell you a sentiment. Because by you being here is great for us. So not for you, but great for us. So listen to what I'm saying.
For the ratings.
What I'm saying is this. When you normally are at the NAACP and you're conducting your meetings and you're talking, doing everything, how much time do you normally take for a lunch?
30 minutes or so.
Okay, all right. I like that. I feel good about our people. I feel good right now because if you would have said like 2 hours, I'd be like, this dude ain't helping us out at all, brother. This cat over at TJ Reels, man, he doing something else. Anyway.
He had help out.
Come on, man. All right, so 30 minutes now. 30 minutes is not a lot of time. But for some, it can work. Not trying to judge, but sometimes Thursday work. Okay. So, what's going to happen is that there's going to be a phone call placed, okay? Now, we're going to have the lovely Kelsey be here, and she's calling you, okay? I'm sorry. Yeah, wait, hold on. Wait. Yeah, she's calling you, and she's going to try to get you to do some lunchtime loving with her. Now, again, she's going to tell you what to eat. She's going to tell you everything else. It's up to you now to close this deal. All right. NAACP version.
First of all,
lunchtime lovers.
I cannot
civil rights.
Seduce this man. He's a part of the NAACP. He's a very important member of the community.
Even Malcolm and Barton had to get some work.
Now, let's not talk about Malcolm and Barton.
I think I might got the perfect item.
We'll do lunchtime smooching, okay? We ain't going to go all the way to loving. Lunchtime smooching.
I know smooching feel kind of invasive though.
All kind of evasive.
I mean,
right,
I'd rather love it. Because you never know. Loving could be a hug.
Okay. It could be.
It ain't got to be full brigade. Like,
you know what? I need to ring this phone.
All right, ring the phone. Here we go.
Call
all right.
The phone.
And it's real quick. It'll be over quick. Don't worry about it.
What happened to that boy?
Now you got to answer the phone, Eugene.
Answer the phone, Eugene.
Hello.
How you doing?
I'm all right, baby.
Oh. I was just calling to see if you wanted this nice 1,000 count sweat jacket. What they call them, suit jackets.
Suit jackets.
It's a 1,003 count.
Oh, a 1,003 count. Okay,
cotton.
Silky smooth.
It's a burnt orange color. I think burnt orange your color.
Yeah, burnt orange. That's my thing right there.
And I think I want to put you on some gray pants with it.
Great sweatpants.
I feel like that'll hit nice off the NAACP skin.
Oh man. I tell you what, baby, I'm on the way.
You on the way? Ooh, you
damn,
was
it wasn't even a lot.
Okay.
Wow.
All right.
He was easy.
And that was
lunchtime loving for you.
That was not as hard as we thought.
Your jam was pretty easy.
Yeah, I thought I got this.
Counselor.
Yeah.
Politic. Whatever.
Never say no.
Yeah.
And man, I've been watching your bus series too, on Instagram.
You heard that, Dre? Cut the music, Dre.
Man,
he's been watching the bus series. That's
man,
what's up.
I love him, man. And I saw the one with the golf club.
The fork.
That was
the
cool.
The fork. Yeah, the fork was crazy.
Man, I don't think it helped me.
The NAACP wants to do a bus series with you.
Really?
We want to do one with you.
What?
We want to do one with
you. Oh my God.
it's here.
Tell my wife that. You hear that, baby? To hear that, the stuff you telling me not
the
to go date it.
Yeah. So NAACP wants to work with you.
I appreciate that. So the bus series, for those who don't know, I started this chapter, kind of like NAACP started a chapter. I started a chapter called Bust, all right? Baton Rouge Urban Survival Tactical Unit, all right? It's actually self-defensivist tactics, all right?
But
it's
kind of
showing
area.
You what not to do whenever you were confronted with a weapon.
This
with
stuff
the great
will only happen in the BR area.
Adrian B. Yeah, only happened there. So, only. Yeah, so I will take that challenge. I would love to do it. Would you be in it with me?
Man, I plan on doing it with you.
Oh, nice. Okay, awesome.
Oh, man. Can I awesome. Join?
Yeah, absolutely.
Absolutely. Can I join?
It's, but we need some members. We need some unit. We need some members because I started with 17. Now it's only me left. So I've been trying to recruit. They're not dead or nothing. They just start doing other stuff. So anyway, so I need
they just
the other people.
Survive the tactics.
Yeah, yeah. So good. So now we're going to go to a quick commercial break. We're going to come back with our musical guest for the evening. We close out the show now with a musical guest. So again, it's been Eugene Collins, president of the BR NAACP. Eugene, you good? Anything you want to say, man? Anything left?
Nah, check out our radio show on Sunday at 5 o'clock. The NAACP President Show, WTQT
106.1 FM. 106.1 FM. Make sure you tune in. I've listened. It's good, informative. Guys, seriously, we need y'all to get involved. We need us black men. We need people to help. We need people to change our community. And this is the way to do it. It starts here. Don't say you don't see what's going on when he right here. All right? Right here, okay? And he dressed nice. He together. All right.
He's dressed nice. He's smooth and he smells.
So we'll be back, and we at the grind.
We at the grind.
Hey, it's your girl, 40 Bars. Y'all know anytime I'm in Baton Rouge or anywhere for that matter, and I want to get fly and be comfy at the same time, keep this drip and all that, y'all know? I got Ville Life clothing on my back. Y'all make sure y'all follow them. Fuck with me. Bars.
Those are burnt.
It's your girl Tubby of the Nerdy Bird site and antidote.com. I am bringing you another exclusive episode of Kicking the Real.
One time for the one time, and if one time ain't good enough, we definitely got to do it twice. DJ A Twice, formerly known as DJ Baby Urkel. Follow me at DJ A Twice on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. And check out my exclusive interview with Tubby, the antidote.
Tell her you don't want to miss this, Kicking the Real.
Okay, we back here at C Bazz Cast. Having fun.
We're gonna have to redo the redo.
We gotta redo it again?
We might have to redo the redo.
Oh my God. We gotta redo it again?
No, we good.
Okay, good. C Bazz Cast, C Bazz itself, shout out to the Grime, shout out to E Media, shout out to Eugene Collins coming through. Wes Ross, Kelsey B, DGYMC. We gotta end the show like none but never before. We gotta end the show with a hot performing artist, young rapper, up and coming, killing the game, right here out of Baton Rouge. Show some love for Jew Major. Welcome, welcome. I'm about to hand over to you. You know what I'm saying? That's Kelsey's West. We signing off. It's your show now, dog. You got it? All right, take us away, bro.
Ready, boss?
Hey, what's up, y'all? What's up, y'all? My name's Jew Major. We about to rock out. Shout out to C Bazz Cast, my bad brother.
It's all right. We had a long
Black
day.
Black excellence. We in the building. Come on now, fourth quarter pressure, Jew Major. That's right. Yeah. Hey, shout out to the antidote. Shout out to the grind. We in the building. Shout out to the bar. Don't forget the bartender. Don't forget to tip the bartender. Yeah. With a bad bitch smoking his eye. On bears, it feel like I'm chopping. All the rats got me from the cocking. Say you live, but we really is popping. I was hungry, I wanted with cheese. Now I'm having that shit all on me. Take a bath with that feeling with weed. You pussy boys ain't in my league. Head on the spot. We gon' rock out with that Glock. We're tryna be something you not. Yeah, we gon' make this bitch hot. You think that you fucking with me? Please, make your bitch get on my foes, hands, and knees. I can cross what they say, you never see haters at the bank. Never give a fuck what they think, just doing his song. Mood on walk a flock, going hard in the pan. All this Mississippi got me finna fan with a version off in creative ways. Need to have my face, all the rest got me finna cocky. I'm embarrassing, feel like I'm chopping, but I'm bad, smoking is at it. I was talking about I wanted with cheese, now I'm having that shit all on me. Take a bag when they fill it with weed. Yeah, you pussy boys out of my league. Say you live but we really is poppin'. But a bad bitch smoking inside. You pussy boys out of my league. Say you live but we really is poppin'. But a bad bitch smoking inside. Whoa, fuckin' with my niggas on freeze. Yeah, it's rich, yeah. It's poppin' who droppin' like me. Whoa, yeah, I'm out of speed. River Pod, I come from that three. Whoa, yeah, I'm the golden, no colder than me. Yeah, nigga, the box, I'm so out the docks. You all the down, I'm turned up a notch. We movin' them pounds, I'm out of clock. I got what you want, come over and shop. I can't stop, I stick up a Glock. I'm runnin' big goofy, get beat up and pop. I'm runnin' the miles, so wait till the tide. These hoes get wrong for niggas with crap. Runnin' with pieces of leaders, it's better than TV. I think from that name, you niggas can't see me. Oh, I miss my brother, I feel like no reason. That chop on your top of what's up. I so you fucking with you, get it like a move. I smoking this cause you been smacking her booty. I'm pretty like Ricky and Tony and Juicy. I'm spreading it while I be kissing that goose. All they rats got me fucking cocky. I'm embarrassed, feel like I'm trapped. With a bad bitch smoking his ass. Yeah. I was hungry, I wanted with cheese. Now I'm having that shit all on me. Take a bath with it, fill it with weed. Yeah, you pussy boys ain't in my league. Say you live but we really is poppin'. With a bad bitch smoking his ass.
Yeah,
you pussy boys ain't in my league. Say you live but we really is poppin'. With a bad bitch smoking his ass. By the time this bitch too major, four quarter pressure. Hey, shout out Webby. Hey, turn up. Let's go. Hey, shout out EQ. We in the building. Shout out to the Antidote.
That's that old Trill fam,
yeah.
B.
Turn up.
Let's go.
Hey, let's go.
Major.
Hey, too major. Four quarter pressure.
Major.
King. Yeah,
let's go.
Riding down your block, ayy, with that slap bullshit. Bitch, don't play me wrong. We got tools in this bitch, I hope come wipe me down. That chicka train came too quick and we can go for rounds. I'm not, I can't do swerving about Persian. We fall through on back up since sliding in excursion. Big rims on it like a Mack truck with a foreign chicken, she purging. I have regional cameras. You bitch niggas ain't saying nothing, I'm the right one. Niggas strapped with a slap, yeah, I ride like that. Chicken ass with my bitch smoking on that strong pack. Just left the store, we got some goodies. My back bullets full of threats. You want your bitch, I give them back. Just finish stretching out a cake, yeah. I'm flashing on purpose, cause back then I was hurting. I chewed up my crew up, and that meat was a little chew up. And I rolled hard up a few plants, while rolling up a whole new plant like Birdman.
Chew,
and I do stuff
chew,
in the base,
chew, chew,
lies on my bitch, you gotta ask that match. Fuck it, I done told my cousin, you can have that 12. Gon' get your shine on that 2 and 2, I done bounce back. I done turned up with these racks, now these hoes are
shut
all
up, the antidote.
Fuck with you, you get spread. We're three baby going brains, and pour a lie straight from that bank. I put that wood up on them. Fight out to the king of rap. I heard you tape, your shit was wet. Please stop calling me for the track, yeah. Riding down your block, ayy, with that slap bullshit. Bitch, don't blame me wrong, huh? We got tools in this bitch, I hope come wipe me down. That chicka train came too quick and we can go for rounds. I can't just swerve in about purging. We fall through whole back up since sliding in excursions. Big rims on me like a Mack truck. With a foreign chicken, she purging. I have reason up camo, so you bitch niggas ain't saying nothing. I'm a right one, these bitch niggas don't make believe, making up shit like Maybelline. If it's white card, then it's shake clean. Depending on the mood, then I Maybelline. Like Project Big, I'll get green. Just doing shit that you never seen. Still breaking off my fucking team. Don't look me up. I'm flashing on purpose, cause back then I was hurting. Chewed up my crew up, and that meat was a little chew up. Rolling hard up a few plants, while rolling up a whole new plant. Like Birdman, all I do is the interface kicking
you
up.
Chew, bitch!
Yeah, riding down your block, ayy. With that slap bullshit, bitch, don't play me wrong, yeah. We got tools in this bitch, I hope come wipe me down. That chicka train came too quick and we can go for rounds. I'm not, I can't do swerving about purging. We fall through whole back up since sliding in excursion. Big rims on it like a Mack truck. With a foreign chicken, she purging. I have reaching up cameras. So you bitch niggas ain't saying nothing. I'm the white one to get this bitch from.
Hey,
huh?
Hey,
Two Major. Fuck me on
Chew,
all platforms.
Chew, Major.
Follow me on the ground, man. I'm Fisher, Two Major.
Fuck
all the pressure. Shout out to the
Chew, Major.
Shout out to the Antidote. We in the building, man. Black X. Shut up.